was a poor man with a Bible, preaching barefoot in the snow. His clothes are torn and tattered, but he says he doesn't build a boat. The boys on Wall Street call him Moses. He told me his name was Jim, and he had a smile that seemed to come from within. The rich man passed him by, said, get a job, man, get a home. And he stood there and looked at Moses, amazed at what he saw. Jim smiled and said, dear brother, I have all I need and more. And I have a job, I work for the be so excited about what our Lord has done. We take this gospel out of four walls and let them see the sun. Well, it's time to be kicking into the streets, taking into the streets. Let this world see what it's really.
Tried so hard to put up a fight. The Holy Spirit knocked on his heart's door, and he said these words as his feet hit the floor. He said, I hear you knocking, but you can't come in. Rejecting Jesus to live in my sin. I know I'll be worse off in the end, but I hear you knocking, but you can't come in. Got away, he wouldn't have to deal with conviction today. But riding down the road one afternoon, he heard that voice again, but he gave him no room. He said, I hear you knocking, but you can't come in. Rejecting Jesus to live in my sin. I know I'll be worse off in the end, but I hear you knocking, but you can't come in. Judgment, he fell on his face, begging Jesus just to give him grace. He remembered all of his sins and these words he'd said time and again. He said, I hear you knocking, but you can't come in. Rejecting Jesus to live in my sin. I know I'll be worse off in the end, but I hear you knocking, but you can't come in. I hear you knocking, but you can't come in. I
knocking, but you can't come in.
We're so happy. Everybody's dancing now, 'cause we're so happy.
Bye.
hung on a cross and died. Oh, how it made us cry. We tried to hide our foolish pride, but our sins, they'll all be seen in the end. What have you done for the Father and His Son? Why so few? Did my Lord suffer and die in vain? Did my Lord suffer and die in vain?
Scars and disgrace, but you meet me here in spite of my shame. Your blood covers it all, and you carry me away, and I throw my hands up in the air. Here's my heart, 'cause I don't care what they say about me.
Mary was great with child. She came to the inn. The innkeeper said, "No room, I can't let you in." He was the first one to turn him away.
Friends, let me ask you a question. Do you have Jesus living in your heart? Have you made room for him to live inside of your heart? Have you asked him to come in to be your Lord and Savior? I pray that you have. And if not, let today be the day that you allow him to come into your heart. Don't turn him away. Sometimes we think because we do all good, we do all good things, and we think we can make it by our works, but that's not the way it is, friend. You can be the best person around. You can pay your bills. You can be on every church roll in the community. You'd be the most outstanding person that there is, but that does not save you, people. You got to have Jesus live within. You have got to ask the Lord. You got to ask Jesus, say, "Will you come and live within my heart?" On the flip side, it doesn't matter how bad you have been. You could be the most foul sinner that has ever been on the face of this earth. And if you will bow down and ask Jesus to come and live in your heart and forgive you your sins, he will do just exactly that. In Romans 10 and 13, it says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You see, my friend, salvation is not for sale. You don't have and never will have enough money to buy it, but it's a free gift, and all you got to do is ask, ask, and it shall be yours.
We forgot.